cognitive and something developmental, Satan. Young people.
And I must say that all of the organizers, because they already took the risk to spread it to the whole Bangladesh, and definitely FNF, I must thanks to take the opportunity to extend their hands with us. And at the same time, RTV, and if I'm not wrong, the first time when you organized, RTV also took this initiative to work with us. And I also like to thanks and show my gratitude to all of the participants. As you understood that the whole country, you are trying your best to represent yourself. I love to say that the participants, those who already joined, those who will get the recognition as a winner, please don't lose your confidence. Keep it up, your spirit, so that they get in the ring and these sorts of competition can proudly say that, yes, you already started your journey from this get in the ring. Thank you very much. And wish all of you good luck and hope that it will be a great successful event.
Thank you. উদ্যোগ গ্রহণ করতে চাই যে উদ্যোগের ফলে আমাদের তরুণরা চাকুরি খুঁজবে না, তারা চাকুরি দেওয়ার ব্যবস্থা করবে। এই রিং এ কিন্তু একজন আরেকজনের সাথে শুধু প্রতিদ্বন্দ্বিতাই করছে না, তারা একজন আরেকজনের সাথে কিন্তু কোলাবোরেট করছে এবং নেটওয়ার্ক বিল্ড করছে। তিনটা স্টেক হোল্ডারের কোলাবোরেশন খুব প্রয়োজন, ইন্ডাস্ট্রি, একাডেমিয়া এন্ড গভর্নমেন্ট। আমরা এই তিনটা পক্ষের কোলাবোরেশনের মধ্য দিয়ে আমরা বাংলাদেশকে বিশ্বের বুকে একটি ইনোভেটিভ নেশন এবং স্টার্ট আপ নেশন হিসেবে গড়ে তুলতে চাই। এ বিষয়ে আপনাদের সকলের সহযোগিতা কামনা করে আপনাদের যারা অংশগ্রহণকারী আছেন, যারা আজকে বিজয়ী হবেন তাদেরকে অভিনন্দন, এবং যারা অংশগ্রহণ করেছেন হয়তো বিজয়ী হতে পারেননি বা পারছেন না তাদের জন্য আমার শুভকামনা জানিয়ে আমার বক্তব্য এখানেই শেষ করছি। আমরা অবজয়ী, আমরা দুর্বার, ডিজিটাল বাংলাদেশ বিনির্মাণে আইসিটি হবে হাতিয়ার। জয় বাংলা, জয় বাংলা।
I will be moderating the four battles that we're going to witness now between eight teams, companies, however we name them, and they have actually come from the previous round where 16 teams participated. Let's get to the first battle, and it is my great pleasure to welcome the two teams on, or rather into the ring. The first team coming is Team Ishara. Welcome back, Team Ishara. Give me a hug. And battling against Team Ishara is My Car, My Life. Welcome back. Your 60-second introduction.
Aisha is my little cousin who lives in a small town in Rongpur. Unlike you and me, she isn't blessed with the ability to speak or hear. Yes, she belongs from the mute and deaf community. And also, she wants to learn sign language, but however, there are no special schools around her that teach this. So in a situation such as this, how would Aisha express herself? Will she be able to talk to her parents? So just like Aisha, there are 30 lakh people in Bangladesh who currently belong to the mute and deaf community, and the amount of resources available for them is simply disappointing, as there's only one sole organization called SDSL working towards this purpose, whereas in the entire country, there are only 7 government schools that teach Bangla Sign Language. Also, a significant portion of this population are unemployed, making them a burden on the society. So considering this, we introduced you Ishara, which is the first ever open learning platform teaching Bangla Sign Language, providing sign language education in specific fields of expertise, and also connecting them towards feasible job opportunities. Our target market involves the mute and deaf community, the families, and anyone else who wants to learn Bangla Sign Language. Our mission is to provide quality education, reducing inequality while working towards feasible job opportunities.
Okay, my car, my life, your introduction. Accidents are created as disease, and we are creating the ground for them. It's not my statement, stated by Dr. Sirajul Islam, former director of NITOR. 10 to 15,000 people die in a year, and thousands or millions are injured because of the accident, and economic value is more than 5,000 crore taka. United Nations coined as 7th most important problem out of the top 10 problems. We all know prevention is better than cure, but majority of the accidents occurs because of the failure of maintenance of the vehicle, using right spare parts, and service done through the right mechanics. So, we are here to introduce the total solution before you buy a car to the disposal of the car. And not only that, to ensure your lifestyle, you have a better life. There is no hassle while you are going for the registration. We will offer the documentation. We will offer insurance. We will offer parking. To think about the situation, you have gone outside for the travel.
Ishara, your business model and market.
With a market size of 90 lakh people, being the first movers in this niche market, we will be receiving a competitive advantage as we will be working towards feasible partnerships. So our business model basically involves we will be going for subscription-based model depending on the advanced courses, such that upon availing the advanced courses, you will be receiving a certification of achievement from which you will be certified as a sign language specialist. This will act as a prerequisite working towards feasible job opportunities. We also intend to introduce a B2B model.
Okay, my car, my life, your business model and market.
Total market size is about 5,000 crore taka, and we are targeting 15% market share within next 2 years. And our customer includes B2B, B2C, B2G, as well as C2C. Apart from this, we will earn revenue through subscription, direct sales, on-demand servicing, royalty, commission. That's all.
Okay, now the financials and proposition of Ishara.
Ishara is currently in its incubation phase, and through the process, we have received a positive consumer feedback. We will be going into collaboration. We have been proposed for collaboration with certain institutions. So through this process, we have received 178 paying customers through the process, and we will be reaching our break-even upon achieving only 5,640 subscribers, which is only 0.18% of this huge market. So we will be proposing for 26 lakh rupees startup, for which we will be working.
My life, your financials and proposition.
Okay, till date, we have invested 67 lakh taka. Our net profit, profit is around 57 lakh. We are looking for 2 crore taka against the equity of 25%. And we need the fund to develop our database as well as SMS management. Apart from this, we are going to offer the services like car servicing, spare parts sourcing, vehicle, driver and mechanic sourcing, as well as we are, as part of CSR, we are going to offer free mechanic servicing and as well as free in different areas.
Okay, gentlemen, thank you very much. Now the floor is open for questions from the honorable judges.
I would like to know a little more on your contingency plans. In case if your financial projections or the proposition that you mentioned, that does not work out, what are your contingency plans?
Let's start with Ishara.
Currently, we are working towards a B2B model, B2C model, which involves a subscription-based financial model. But however, if we cannot reach out to the individual peoples, we will be introducing an augmented reality project such that it will go through smart books. So what we intend to propose here is that, as we know, a certain proportion of this population remains in the rural areas. So for this process, we are already working in affiliation with certain companies and seeking their CSR project funds. So through the process, firstly, we will be collaborating with the NGOs, as a result, allowing us to reach out potentially to the rural areas and providing the service there, making our market there. So that is the intent that we want to follow. And also, as I have already mentioned, that we are going to introduce a VR-based model that is going to be global, such that when you get in the game, you'll be able to select any possible language that there already exists. And what this will do, this will also allow you to adapt to certain real-life scenarios, making you more able in the society. So through the process, it will also act as an e-commerce platform. Let me give an example. For example, I just walk into a store, and there are certain dresses that are already existing there. So through the process, I tell them that this is one particular, through my sign language, I tell them this is the particular dress that I want. And upon selecting that dress, it will be delivered at my doorstep through the process, and a certain commission will be received for Ishara in the process. These are the contingencies that we already planned in case things go wrong.
Your contingency plans.
Yeah, we have proven experience, and our experience is based on the automobile industry. Like we told, prevention is better than cure. We are mainly, you have already introduced the required automobile equipment that are the quick equipment to diagnose the service, as well as how we diagnose our business plan also, how we can meet the contingency. So we have already tied up with the leading suppliers who can supply at an affordable price the best product verified by us. And we have already connected with the key partners whom we are going to sell our products. And apart from this, we have already stock of customers. So from the beginning of our journey, we are earning revenue. If we are not getting the fund immediately, we will not drive, because we have the customers, we have the network, and we have the channel partners also who can give us the required device, service, equipment. Insurance companies are also, there is no investment required because they are live. We are getting the commissions from them. For parkings also investment is not required, because there are some places inside Dhaka, even outside Dhaka, the opportunity is more, because the parkings are left for the daytime, and we can use it when the visitor visit that place. That's how we can meet our contingency in the short term as well as in any time.
Okay, thank you very much. So that concludes the questions from the judges.
Hi, good evening. I am Sharad Rahman. I am the co-founder and CEO of Amar Astha Limited. We are a technology-based home care service company. Let me give you a real story. Nusrat lives in Basabu. She works in a very good position in an NGO. She has a son of 1 year old. Her grandmother is a bedridden patient. Her mother has really tough time to manage the family with the kid and the patient. Sometimes Nusrat thinks of quitting her job and manage the family by herself. In this case, Amar Astha Limited has been a real solution of the problem of Nusrat. We provided nanny for her kid, nurse for her grandmother, and her mother and grandmother takes physiotherapy services from us. We also provided diagnosis services for her grandmother, And we also have speech therapy and occupational therapy for special children.
Okay, thank you very much. The Polyfins Technology, your introduction.
I am Farid Milun. I am the CEO, co-founder of Polyfins. You wake up in the morning, you see red in your skin. What are you going to do? There is one doctor per 2,000 patients. There is one nurse for 10,000 patients. There is no such kind of app available to do the analysis of your problem. Here we come. You just take a picture of your problems area and give your symptoms. It will tell you the prediction of your probable conditions. And through the app, you can take the online consultation. You can do the chat with the doctors, know more about your disease. Our app is machine learning. We use the machine learning and deep learning technologies. We are covering 90% of common skin disease. We are following the FDA guidelines. And as per the research, we found that it's 85% clinically accurate of our data. So that's where we are stand. Thank you.
Okay, Amar Asta Limited, your business model and market.
Our business model is quite simple. We take around 13% of commission from each transaction. Our market size is quite huge. We have calculated 25 billion taka in every year. Our target clients are working women, special children, and patients. We are targeting to get 1.5% of total market share by 2022. And our competitors are like daycare centers and other companies, but we are technology-enabled companies who can manage the business very smoothly. And we have the fast service.
Okay. $2 billion healthcare market in Bangladesh. We are targeting $25 million from that. $2.35 billion is pharma market. We are targeting $10 million from that. Our business model is in subscribe model and the one-time charges model. We are at daily basis model as well. You can take the referral service. Online pharmacies also there. So you from sitting in the home, you can take the services from the specialist dermatologist as well as you can take the medicine to
anybody. Financials and proposition, Amar Asta.
So far, we have raised 70 lakhs taka as angel investment. Our burn rate is 2.5 lakhs taka every month. We are planning to expand our business also in Chittagong and Narayanganj. We are hopeful that in next 3 years, total 3 years from the business will be get in break-even point.
Yeah, financials and profits.
Okay, so our burning rate is 2.5 lakhs taka per month. We are earning, so far we raised 30 lakhs taka, and we are looking for 1 crore taka for 20% share to business development and promotions and the business extension of the services and digitalize it. We want to take a part of this country's digitalization.
Thank you very much. That concludes. The questions are going to come from the judges.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
And my question is for both of you, do you find any challenge in your business model and how you like to address that challenge?
For us, it's the awareness problem and the trust issues we are facing right now. Like the Bangladeshi's people are right now, they are not quite too acceptable the digital treatment. So there we stand. We are making the awareness program in different. We recently did the partnership with Ruby through them and with the pharmacies, NGOs. We are working in the remote areas where the people come from there to the medical stores. As per our data analysis, people are more comfortable go to the medical store compared to the doctors in the village areas. So there we want to take part of that evolution.
Amar Asta, for our business, the most challenging part was finding the right caregiver, especially the nanny. Fortunately, we have got some of them. And we are planning to have some with institutions like Dakota University. They will have a daycare center in future. Maybe we'll propose them to give trained caregivers to us so that we can employ them. I would also like to thank the ICT Ministry for giving us a chance to verify the NID and birth certificate of every caregiver. So the challenge have been reduced to verify the background of every caregiver.
Okay, thank you, judges. I think that's all the time.
Polyfins Technology.
So you have 60 seconds for your introduction.
So I was reading an article, a university student wrote that he is being compelled to choose between his university fees and buying insulin. That should not happen, right? Because whoever has diabetes, that...
Limited. Let me tell a problem you are facing every day. Every time you tie your shoes, you desire office functional shoe rack where you can sit on it and tie your shoes in a convenient way. But realistic case scenario is that you will not find that product according to your preferred measurement and preferred color. So here we come in. We offer custom-made multifunctional space-saving furniture according to client's preferred measurements, color, materials, and other requirements. Basically, to sum up, we are architects tailoring furniture. Our case study was on IKEA, Paperfly, and Alpha Labor from India and Hatil from Bangladesh. Thank you.
Okay, Easy Lynn, your business model and market.
Our business model is a business-to-customer approach. We have a market size of 400 million people using insulin globally right now. Of them, 6 million people are residing in Bangladesh. So the projected yearly revenue from our product will be 60 to 77 crore taka. We'll reach the break-even point after the launch in less than 6 months. So we can say that with this precise business model, insulin will not only be affordable, it will be profitable. Thank you.
Minimal Limited, your business model and market.
Our market size is 6,600 crore ability in domestic market, and the global market is 66 billion. And our customer segment is 20 to 45 age, mostly 50 plus K earners, and corporate office, bank, restaurants, and government institutions, and also tender participation. Our market profit margins comes to 25% from furniture supply, 30% from interior project, and 60 to 70% from architectural consultancy projects. Since in customer segment is recently featured, and
financials and propositions.
So we have a $42 billion industry of insulin. Initially, we are targeting only $10 billion. After gaining the trust and building our fan base, we will increase our market. So we'll be needing a 40 lakh taka of investment to develop our product. Right now, we have connected to the ICT Innovation Fund, like Paula sir mentioned. We have applied for the funds. So we're thinking that we are going to get that fund and do our job.
Our current market, current monthly burning is 6,50,000 taka, and in September, we achieved 30 lakh taka plus work order. Initial investment was supported by the co-founders, and currently we are raising for P-Series A fund, which is 3 crore BDT against 10% investment and on directorship position. Expected ROI will be 3 years.
And the judges, your questions.
For EasyLean, my question is that why people will go, that's the one thing. Because the current market is highly dominated by the products that are available.
Yes.
So market will listen to profit.
Yes. Yeah.
So how you will deal with that?
Yes, the current market is very dominating. The 42 billion industry is now controlled by only 3 companies, Novo Nordisk, Eli Lilly and Sanofi. So we are going against competition with those companies. But the thing is, people are dying because they are not lowering their prices. There is even an online petition that is being signed to lower the prices of insulin, but they are not paying any heed to the people. So, you see, we are paying heed to the people. We are considering what they can afford. We are considering the people of Bangladesh, India, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, people of these countries who cannot afford those high-priced insulin that they need. So, yes. That is how we will reach our customers.
Thank you very much.
For more updates, subscribe and press the bell icon on YouTube app and never miss another update.